Hello for the boys and girls at home. My name is Amel Amin.
Amel, it's fantastic to have you tonight. You excited about the screening?
I'm definitely excited about it. You know, I'm very proud of Femi Raineer, and he's did a big feat making an independent British film, independently financed, independently distributed. I'm very proud of what he's achieved tonight.
What's the importance of independent film, both for filmmakers and for audiences, do you think?
What you get with independent film is authentic stories. And I think also what you get with independent films is, you know, being able to really distribute humanity equally. You know, when you get studio films, they're fantastic, they're great. But independent film is the heart of the people still. People being able to get their narrative told in a big way.
I think diversity has been a big word in the international and the UK film industry over the past 12 months. How far do you think we've got to go to tackle that specific issue?
I mean, we've got to uphold our creatives. We've got support. You know, I live in Los Angeles. I was here for my birthday, and I thought, yeah, I'm going to come and support Femi. I think diversity, or I think telling the full spectrum of the human experience, is imperative to everybody. Otherwise, we get this one-sided view of who everyone is. You know, if I think about what an Italian-American is, you think Goodfellas, Godfather, and you get one specific lens. You think about what an African-American is, you might think Boys in the Hood and be like, oh, that's them. You know, so I think it's imperative in this day and age where most of people's education, young people's education, is from film, television, reading, you know, media. It's very important for us to tell everybody's story in its fullness. As an actor, I have a film coming out at Sundance, Star of June, and another one coming out at Toronto Film Festival. And as a filmmaker, there is a lot going on. There's a lot going on that I can't quite speak on quite yet.
I mean, talking about those two films you've got coming out at the festivals, can you just tell us very quickly a little bit about both of those?
Okay, yeah, Star of June is about Nigerian-American Wall Street financier who's struggling with his cultural identity. He's struggling with what it means to be a Nigerian American in America, and it's somewhat of an immigrant story trying to find his way, and he ends up falling in love with a white lady who's American, have an interracial relationship, and there's a big element of stock exchange fraud. So it's a big drama, and I really look forward to it. It's by a young director called Anthony Ona. He's a new filmmaker and very powerful one of that.
The other film that you've got, Toronto?
Yes, Soy Nero, which is another. Soy Nero is about a Mexican green card soldier and him getting his stay in America and fighting for the war. And what was happening a lot of the time, they were sending people away after in Vietnam and in the Bush wars. They were sending Mexican green card soldiers away and back to Mexico. And so Rafi Pitts, this fantastic author who did The Hunter, was at the Berlin Film Festival just now. He created this story. He thinks it's very important to tell. And so that's Toronto. It's at Binner Berlin, and the next one's at Sundance.
Hi, my name is Richard Blackwood, currently on EastEnders, play Vincent, and I'm here to support my boy Femi with his film tonight.
Richard, why was it so important for you to come along and support Femi in this film tonight?
Femi and I are good friends. We work together in another hood, right? I know him with Amel, right? Obviously, they come up through kidhood, and they're the new, they were, because they're now veterans, the new faces from the urban scene, taking it mainstream. And to see Femi make his second movie now, right, you know, and having the turnout that it has, he emailed me, said, Richard, could you come down? I said, he calls me uncle. And I said, I have to be there. So no, I'm here to support, he's my boy.
What for you is the importance of independent cinema, both for filmmakers and for audiences, do you think?
I think it gives people that driving incentive to know that they don't necessarily have to go through a major. You know, like, it's a different time now. The internet, people are making films now on next to nothing. And even the internet are blowing up certain people right now. You've got Terrell Lewis, who's outside, internet sensation. And that's what's happening now. The public are speaking and the public are saying, we want to see this and we're not going to turn to you if you're going to make it over here. So I think that now this is a call for all the major networks, the major business and corporations to come and say, listen, we need to back you because you guys are finding the back door in, basically.
Of course, diversity has been an important and a controversial word in the past 12 months. How do you think we're rising to meet that challenge, particularly here in the UK creative industry?
I think we're doing very well out here. Like, considering we live in the UK and it's such a small island, I think we're doing very well. We're seeing a lot more black people on the TV. I'm on EastEnders. We've got a black family on EastEnders, right? A loving couple. We've got Patrick that plays the grandfather, Denise that plays the sister and, you know, the aunt. So we've got that. We had Masood right? Nitta that plays Masood. We've got diversity on TV. Of course, there's space for much more, but we're doing very, very well right now. And I think the UK should be very proud because we're really breaking some new grounds.
What's life like as part of the Enders family now?
it's brilliant. I like going to work. It doesn't feel like work. Everybody there, it's a family unit. We get our storylines, we gasp and we go and do it and hope that the people love it. And so far, so good. So I'm really happy there.
You talk about the storylines. Is there any you've been involved with so far that you're especially proud of? Because, I mean, obviously the show does push boundaries and it does ask important questions.
I think my most proud was going up against Phil Mitchell. Like, you can't beat that. Like, that's making history. Steve is such a given actor. And, you know, and I guess I was allowed to play his nemesis. And it also allowed Vincent to be established in Wolford in the square. So I've got a lot of love for Steve for allowing that to happen. So that's probably my biggest moment.
Have you got a message to Enders fans before you leave us tonight?
Enders fans, just keep watching, keep supporting. And Vincent's going to keep doing his thing. You know, he's nice, but you know he's bad at the same time. He likes to play the middle.
Hi, I'm Lauren. So I've just come off Love Island. The highlight of the experience is obviously meeting the rest of the cast. They're all amazing. We got on so well. It was, it was a lot of fun. I think it was a huge hit because it was so genuine. Like the couples, even though that doesn't translate as well, but when I got in there, you realise how genuine everyone is. And like it's real relationships, real arguments. So I think that makes good TV.
I mean, talking about real relationships, the show obviously caused a bit of controversy this year because of some of the scenes that were shown. As a contestant, how did you feel about that?
Well, fortunately or unfortunately for me, I didn't have much relationship drama. But I think the controversy always makes a bit of good viewing. I know I'd like to watch that on TV, so I think that's a good thing. I think the fact that Zara lost her title is ridiculous. She's a lovely girl. She's young. She's there. She's having fun. She met someone she's like. She does exactly the same a lot of girls do. So I think it's a bit silly and dated. And I do feel for her that she lost it. But she seems to be doing well. So good luck to her. My plans now are focus on work. Hopefully try and finally find love. Hopefully. But we will see.
Who is your Mr. Right? If people are watching this and would like to apply for the job,
well, Leonardo, if you're interested. But no, I don't know. I go for personality, so just someone I get on with, I guess.
Hi, my name is Mary Ferguson, and I am Miss United Kingdom. I'm so excited to watch Captain Conan's The Intent. I can't wait to watch it. Well, I definitely think it's important to support independent cinema. It's going to be an amazing night and I can't wait to go and watch.
When you're not watching films, what have you got coming up yourself as Miss United Kingdom?
I've got a lot of charity work coming up with the Miss United Kingdom title, which I hold. And I will be doing a lot of charity work throughout the rest of the year until December when my reign ends.
For you, what's been your proudest moment as Miss UK?
As Miss UK, it was actually coming back from the Miss World pageant, holding the title as I went out there as Miss Scotland.
I think the obvious question, how does competing in Miss World compare to the domestic competition?
It's a whole other world, honestly. Everyone was so warm and welcoming, and a month in China was just such a surreal experience. So it was great to go over and be able to experience that.
What was the most surreal thing that happened while you were in China?
Well, there's 114 other girls while we're out there. You get to meet amazing lifelong friends, and it's the weirdest thing. It's the simplest things, like watching the sunrise, which was honestly one of the most beautiful moments I experienced at Miss World. I certainly wouldn't question it because it's great for young girls, it's great for their confidence. It certainly helped me grow as a person, and I've definitely experienced some amazing things throughout my year, and I've come out this year as a different person.
Absolutely fantastic to have you here tonight. You looking forward to the film?
We are.
Can't wait to see some familiar faces.
What have you got coming up yourself?
Well, a brand new single, Let It Go, is out now on YouTube, on iTunes, stream it on Spotify, everywhere. So yeah, check that out.
And if people haven't heard it yet, what's the sound in general? What inspired that song?
Let It Go is about breaking free, living in the moment, enjoying life, and just don't put pressure on yourself. So yeah.
Is that a good indication of what's to come, and is there an album or anything on the way on the back of that single?
Yes, we're working on the album now. Hopefully the end of the year or January it'll be out, but we're working hard. We've got a mix of styles on there, so yeah, just stay waiting, you'll see it soon.
And there's some live dates in between now and then.
Yes, we've got Sundown Festival, which is a good one. Shoreditch House, Kensington Roof Gardens. So yeah, so all the details are on our Facebook page.
Have you got a message to fans before you leave us to enjoy the film here tonight?
Just that we love you. Thank you for our support. No, your support. Thank you for supporting us. And just keep listening to us and keep getting our songs. Go and get Let It Go.